All right. So back to, oh my gosh, another business. No, I really like the art shop. An art shop, yeah. That would be a really good one here in this little tiny local beach community. That would be cool. So yeah, I like that idea. I could be part of that. I would partner into it or whatever. Yeah, and sell pencils. It doesn't have to be a big one like a Bleak. It doesn't have to be, but yeah, a little tiny one where you can get at least some decent supplies and you don't have to drive into the city. So I wouldn't want to drive into the city. But yeah, that's kind of a cool idea. And then even if there was some kind of compositional, I would love to have for the business, for the some kind of an art compositional body. What do we call it? Body artist compositionals, and they could just do that in the window or whatever. And yeah, so we can have like a few artists there that paint, and we can have portraits or what, live humans, models, being painted or drawn or sketched. I like that idea. As like a, what do you call that? An eyeball, a tourist eyeballing thing. Oh, look. But yeah, that's kind of a fun. And then so you can have working artists at. So yeah, that would be a good business, I guess. I guess I could go that way. And I don't know if you all want to participate. It's funny. I don't know. I am in love with colored pencils. What am I going to do? And then I'm going back, why am I in love with colored pencils? I guess another love. Maybe it's just that's the problem, Even my what do you call her? My old young girlfriend from childhood, her father. Oh my gosh. No, he was not a good-looking dude, but I completely, absolutely, secretly in love with him, and he's like 50 years older than me, and it's just like, look at this, that's what he did every day, was the pencils. He just drew and drew and drew. He was an illustrator, and oh my gosh, I learned a lot from him, actually. And I'm trying to, bring it back, exactly what he did, but what an amazing guy, dang. Yeah, you can really be in love with somebody's talents, can't you? And he was amazing because he only listened to opera. He had opera playing every day, and it was just like you enter the house and it was just like that compendium moment, you'd hear the opera radio station. Yeah, and anyway, so he was a funny dude. Well, no, he wasn't funny at all. There was no humor. But one of my favorite people on the whole planet thus far. In what a grouch. What a grouch. Unbelievable. And I was lucky. I was lucky to that she kept me as her friend, and I went over there often enough, and they fed me. So they fed me. The mother fed me. That was so cute. I remember, yeah, like mashed potatoes or something, and oh my gosh, yeah, and her brother, she had an older brother that was like in the, what do you call him? Oh my gosh, he was like in the Navy or something. What an amazing man. She kept him, my girlfriend, she kept him down like in the, I swear she put him down there in the basement or something, keep the amazing man down in the basement. And so Teresa doesn't get to see him very often. Gosh dang it. That, who is that? does he even see me? You're at that age. I think I was like 9, 10, 11. Does he even see me? Oh my God. Yeah. Wow. It's ridiculous. But the father... the father, the artist. I am in such a thrill to go there. You know, I was in such a thrill to go there and just, you know, what is he working on? And he only worked on body paintings. What do you call them? Portraits, sketches, yeah, and you know, lots of nude women, lots of nude women, and so yeah, he was not a brash, conservative sketch artist of apples and pears. No, he made beautiful women, and gosh, yeah. So anyway. What was I talking about? You know, I'm not pining. Anyway, no, I don't want to drive a taxi. I don't care how interesting the conversation is. I don't want to drive a taxi.